Hello guys, I hope you all are fine. Today we are going to see some more SQL Plus commands, like what are the various ways to connect a user in SQL Plus, what is the user password, auto print, markup HTML, and command separator. We'll see that. So without wasting time, let's proceed. So let me connect with what are the various ways to connect to the database. So as you know, we are typing SQL Plus username and password @connection string. This is a one way. Okay, so what is the other way? Other way is like, you see, if I type again connection and I want to connect the user one, so I can write like that, user one and @connection string or instance name /password. So this is the another way to connect to a user. So that is two way we can connect to a user. One is username, password, @database name or connection string or instance name. Another way is username @connection string /password. So let me connect with the user HR. For that I will type connection hr@oracle. Okay, I connected to the HR user. Next command I'm going to tell you what is the user password. So if I type password here, it will ask me to give password is used to create a new password, to change your existing password. So like it is asking me the current password. So I have typed current password. It is asking me the new password. I have inputted the new password and then it is confirming me. So I'm retyping again the new password. You see password has been changed. So again, I can connect HR. So actually the password which I changed, I change it to the same password which I have right now. So this is the use of password. The next command, if I see, that is auto print. So what is auto print? If I want to show what is the value of auto print, you see auto print is off right now. By making it off, we'll see what is the use. You see, let me write a program for that. First, as you know, like to print something, we need to put the set server output on. So I'll do that, set server output on, sorry. So it is on now. Let me show you one function I have, that is select square of number. It will take a single parameter and this function will show me the square of 5. You see, it will fetch the value and it shows 25. So what I'm going to do, I will use this function in a block, in an anonymous block, and I want to retrieve the value and I will store that value into a variable and I will print this. So let's see. For that, I have to create a variable. So I have created a variable that is var1 and it is a number. Okay. Then what I'm going to do, I have to write a block, PLSQL anonymous block. So for that, begin, and I want to store like select square of 5 into v bar 1 from dual, okay, and end. See, okay, what did it happen? Because you see, whenever you will store a value into a variable, at that time we have to use the colon symbol. You see, if I show you here, I need to use colon symbol because it is a bind variable. To store that, we need to use colon symbol, otherwise it will not store. You see, now it PLSQL procedure successfully completed. So now whatever the value of square of 5 is stored in the var 1, how to print that? To print that, I have to type print var1. You see, right now the var1 value is 25. So what happened? Auto print, why it has been introduced? If we make the auto print on, then what happened? We don't need to use this print again. It will automatically, whenever I execute this block, it will automatically print. Let's see. So let me make set auto print on. Okay. And after that, I will execute the same statement here. So it is already there. And let me execute this. You see, when I executed, it automatically shows me the output before I need to print this value. So I hope you understood. The next command is, that is markup HTML. Let's see what is the use of that. So let me see what is the value of that. Markup HTML. So it is off right now, you see, it is off. So how to make it on? Set markup HTML on. So right now it is on. So what I'm going to do, I want to store the employee details into this in a file, and in a file which extension will be .html, and I'm going to open that HTML file in the browser. Okay, for that, as you know, that to store a output in a file, we need to type spool. So spool, I want to make it in F drive HTML folder, and I want to make a file like employee-detail.html. So right now it's okay. Let me write a query. For that, I need to set page size as 500, set line size as 500, and let me write select star from emp. Okay, so it created, and then let me make it off. So if I go to the folder HTML, that f underscore html, you see one file has been created with the HTML extension, and if I open this, you see it shows me in the browser in a tabular manner. It looks good. Okay, I hope you understood. And the next is command separator. What is the use of that? Let's see. First, let me exit from this. So to make it exit, if I type set markup HTML off. So you see, from this SQL underscore GT, I came to SQL prompt. So this is the way to make it off. Next, we'll see what is the use of command separator. For that, let me type show cmd SCP. Now the cmd SCP is off. So let me type set cmd SCP on. Okay. And if I type show cmd SCP, it is showing that it is on, and the separator symbol is semicolon. What is the use of this command? This command is used to work with multiple, using this semicolon operator, we can give multiple commands at a time. Like suppose we know that show all is used to see all the environment variables value, like spool is off, pause is off, all these things. Using the show all command, we can see all the value. But what will, if I want to know only two environments value, like what is the user and what is the verifier? Got my point? What is the value of user and what is the value of verifier? So for that, I need to type like show user along with semicolon, so verify. You see, I type two command, and two command, it works fine. It is showing user is HR and verify is on. So I hope you understood this point. Command separator is used to work with multiple commands at a single time by using this separator symbol, that is semicolon. You can also use another separator symbol also, like set command separator as at pipeline. Okay, you see, and if I type show user and semicolon, it will not work. And if I type show user and pipeline symbol, it will work right now. I hope you understood. So this is the all the uses of various command of SQL Plus. I hope you understood. Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Thanks to all of you.